Father, this morning we envision you rising from that place of rest and standing as we give you praise. And we just glory in your embrace this morning. Father, we love you and we worship you. We give you praise. Beautiful picture. The Father standing, embracing us as his children. Receive our praise. We love you. Amen. So come and rise from your rest and be blessed by our praise, as we glory in your embrace, as your presence now fills this place. This holy place. Amen. You may be seated.
So I find that so amazing, the story of Paul and Silas in the jail, and how that instance of them being in jail brought salvation to the jailer and to his entire household, because they all believed in God. And it was because he saw there was something different about these men. And I'm assuming he felt the presence of God. And so as we wrap up a little bit, I'm sorry, I'm a little bit short-winded this morning. That's just kind of me, so we might just have an early dismissal, if you're okay with that. So just a couple questions as we wrap up here. So what does it look like for us today as we look at hosting the presence of God? What does that look like? And yeah, feel free to just shout it out. But what does it look like to host the presence of God today in 2018 with all our modern technology and our conveniences? You know, what does that look like today to host the presence of God? Just simply creating an atmosphere where we welcome God's presence and he abides here with us. Steve just said it starts in our own heart. Mm-hmm. Yep.
How we respond at the workplace.
How we respond at the workplace? Yeah, way in the back. Mm-hmm. Okay, understanding the essence of God is simply what?
God is love.
Yeah, God is love. Understanding who God is. Yep, and that's so true. God is love.
Yeah, buddy. We host the presence of God, that chains fall off of us.
Okay, I'll just repeat what Buddy said so you can hear it. He just said, when we host the presence of God, chains fall off of us, just like they did with the prisoners. That's true. Yes, Tim.
How you respond when you hear the word of the Lord.
How you respond when you hear the word of the Lord. If you receive it or if you reject it. Yep, very true. Good. Good comments. Yeah.
One thing I noticed in all the examples I gave is there was always praising.
Yep.
Paul and Silas were praising and singing hymns.
Mm-hmm. And that's why Psalms 22, verse 3, thou inhabits the praise of thy people. Yep. And I believe that God inhabits the praise of his people. When we start with worship, I believe that's a sweet smell to God. Yeah. And that there it is again in the World English Bible. You are holy, you who inhabit the praises of Israel. And so I think it's, yeah, it's seeking God and it's praising God. So with that, I think we will close with a word of prayer this morning. And after the prayer, you guys can be excused. So let's pray. Father, we come to you this morning in Jesus' name. And God, we just thank you for your presence here with us. Father, it's our heart's desire that we grow more and more and we learn more and more how to host your presence and how to have your Spirit abide here with us all the time and to have your Spirit resting upon us. Father, I just pray now that you would dismiss each one of us with your blessing and with your peace, and that you would guide the rest of this day. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.